The Bible tells me that God sits in heaven and his eyes moves to and fro the whole earth, seeking those whose hearts are stayed upon him so that he will show himself strong on their behalf.
Formation. That is what we call deformation, and that is what we call transformation. God formed.
Satan came and deformed, but Christ has come to transform. We thank God for transformation. We are grateful to God. The enemies had failed over that family. The enemies had failed over you too. Ancient of days, as old as you are, as old as you are, I say you will never change. Ancient of days, as old as you are, as old as you are, I say, you will never change. The Ancient of Days. You are the original excellency. You are the Igwe of all Igwes. You can kill and you can make alive. You can create a way where there are no ways. You can bring us something out of nothing. You are wonderful. You are powerful. You are merciful. You are excellent. You are mighty. Thank you, Father Lord. Who is like unto thee among the gods? You are greater than the greatest. You are bigger than the biggest. You are stronger than the strongest. You are higher than the highest. You are mightier than the mightiest. You are better than the best. Who is like unto thee among the gods? When you shut, no one can open. When you open, no one can shut. Father, we salute you tonight. Please take all the glory in Jesus' name. Father, I'd like to make this pronouncement. It's a weakness I want to confess. That there is nothing any man of God can do without the God of man. You are the God of man. We may not have a Godfather, but certainly we have God the Father. Lord, perform wonders in our lives. Let our lives reveal your glory. Before this year expires, my Lord, let our mockers bow to our Maker. Open a new chapter for each of us. By your grace. By your grace. One more time. Lord, by your grace, we shall sing a new song. Thank you, Father. Tonight, oh Lord, minister to us. Transform us. Put our enemies to shame. In Jesus' name we are prayed. God bless you. Please be seated. I'd like to appreciate the Almighty God who has brought all of us to church tonight. And I want to rejoice with you, my fathers and my mothers, that today you are not in the cemetery. By the grace of God, you are not in the, mortuary. By God's grace, you are in God's sanctuary. Glory be to God Almighty. And throughout this year, nobody will pay you a condolence visit. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And anyone who wants you dead will replace you in the grave. In the mighty name of Jesus. It doesn't matter what we are passing through in Nigeria. I've said it before and I'm repeating it. And I have it to say on Sunday in Aso Rock that you don't need to go to Germany before you jam your blessings. You don't need to go to UK before you can be okay. Because not everyone in UK is okay. You don't need to go to China before you eat Chinese food. And you don't need to go to France in order to find your fiancé. Where you are here, God will command your blessings to locate you. He says, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Please answer that question. Is there anything difficult for him to do? Tonight, the topic is the God of wonders. God is full or loaded with wonders. That's the reason we call him wonderful. He's full of wonders. Exodus chapter 15, verse 11 is my witness. And it is a song. He said, who is like unto thee, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like thee? You are glorious in holiness. You are fearful in praises. You are doing what? Wonder. Call the wonders, let it have flesh and blood. Wonders. It's a song. Who is like unto thee? Oh. Who is like unto thee? Oh, Lord. Amongst the gods. Who is like thee? Glorious in holiness and fearful in praises. Always doing wonders. Hallelujah. Psalm 77. Psalm 77 verse 14 tells me, it says, thou art the God that doeth wonders. I always say something. Some people fight for their gods, but our own God fights for us. Some people carry their gods, but our own God carries us. He said, thou art the God that doeth wonders. Sometimes, wonders and miracles are used interchangeably. Our God, my God is the God of wonders. But let me correct something here. For every holy thing God has made, there is always a counterfeit made by the devil. So please don't be carried away with the so-called miracles. God can perform wonders because he's the God of wonders. The agents of the devil, too, false prophets and whatever, they too can perform wonders. So be careful. I read that in Matthew 24, 24. Matthew chapter 24, verse 24 says, for there shall arise false Christ and false prophets, and they shall show great signs and wonders, in so much that even if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. You will never be a victim in Jesus' name. Now, let's pay attention to these following possibilities. Number one, God can perform wonders directly. You remember the parting of the Red Sea was done directly by God. The children of Israel, they were like butter in between two slices of bread. The pursuers were behind, Red Sea in the front. So they were like butter. They were afraid, just like we are afraid now in Nigeria. But the Lord told Moses, tell them to move forward. To move forward inside the sea, move forward. The mother of Jesus said, whatever he says unto you, do it. Obedience. And by the grace of God, they move forward and they cross to the other side. You will cross to the other side. Amen. And it's going to be a better side. The children of the pursuers, they thought they would cross. They became food for tilapia. I don't want to pray against your enemies, but they will die for your sake. Am I praying against them? No. Because the owners of evil loads, they must carry their loads. And every arrow shot at any of you will go back to senders. Which year? You are not sure. Which month? Which week? By the grace of God, which day? Today. 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 So God can perform wonders directly. Job chapter 42. You know what happened? Job lost everything. From chapters 1 to 41, there are chapters of losses, of pains, of agony, of bitterness, of sorrow. But God opened chapter 42 for him, the chapter of recovery, the chapter of double portion, the chapter of restoration, the chapter of the finished work of God. Brethren, what God has finished can no longer finish you. God overloaded him, and when you are loaded, you'll be needed. Job became a topic. When you are on top, you become the topic. How many of you want to be on top? So the restoration of Job was done by God. It was a wonder because nobody ever thought he could bounce back. That's why I wonder why some of you are complaining about what is happening in Nigeria. They say the downfall of a man who is in Christ can never be the end of his life. Oh, you think we will continue this way? No way. God will intervene very soon. And he will open a better chapter for us. And we are going to move out of the class of not enough to the class of more than enough. Tap your neighbor. Pastor is talking to me. In the mighty name of Jesus. I used my own as a case study. I had a background. But God didn't allow my background put me on the ground. Amen. Job chapter 9 verse 10. Job chapter 9 verse 10 says, God did great things past finding out. Yea, and wonders without number. Jesus told Peter, let down your nets. But he only had faith for one. Even that one still gave him a net tearing and a boat sinking catch. What would have happened if he had released all the nets? Brethren, you are moving. My son from London is not here. Brother Charles. Somebody came from him, husband and wife. Reverend John knows. And they said, sir, we have been working. We are still tenants. And they brought sand. You know the people? They brought sand. And after we release anointing on the sand, go and throw the sand anywhere you want to build your house. If it is Okokomaiko or Ajangbadi, wherever. This guy, very wise, he just went to Banana Island and poured the sand there. When Brother Charles came home and went to Banana Island, he called me from Banana Island. I said, Daddy, speak to your son. He said, Daddy, do you remember that I brought sand? I said, where did you throw? He said, Banana Island. He said, I'm calling you from my house in Banana Island. And you say, God will not do your own. You are joking. I better chip in this so that you will know where you belong. A commandant said that there are three places in Lagos. Mainland, island, and inland. I've never heard of inland since I've been staying in Lagos. He said, island is Ikoyi, VI, and so. Mainland is Yaba, Onipan, whatever, Surulere. He said, inland, Ajangbadi, Okokomaiko, Idimu, Mushin. Well, I understand. So where do you want? Inland or island or inland? That's number one. He now went further to say, where the rich people are residing, they name their streets after rich people. Makadenuga Close, Adetokunba Ademola, Kalajaye Crescent. What do you expect? It's about where poor people stay. You hear Paco, Vulcanizer, Mangoro, Cement, Ilepo, Idioro. I prophesy. You will change position. The God of wonders will relocate you to a higher level. Which year? So shall it be in the name of Jesus. So the God of wonders can perform wonders directly. Possibility number two, the God of wonders can use any of his angels to perform wonders. You know what happened in John chapter 5? In a place called Bethesda, there was a pool. That pool should have been a healing pool, but to many people it was a swimming pool. God of wonders sent an angel there periodically to trouble the pool. And after the angel had troubled the pool, the first person to jump inside will get in an instant miracle. After that first person, whoever jumped was only swimming. You remember the story of the man with 38 years infirmity? He was there. He had no one to help him. Even the angels that troubled the pool couldn't help the man until Jesus visited the place and singled him out among the crowd. Amen. It is your turn. In the mighty name of Jesus. So, God sent an angel to perform the wonders inside the pool. I told you, that pool was a healing pool to the fast ones. But to the slow people, it was a swimming pool. That man was a spectator, he was a commentator. Combine honor. And you find these two categories of people in every gathering, including the church of God. There are people who come to church to watch. They are spectators. There are people who come to the church to talk. They are commentators. And there are very few people. We call them beneficiaries. If it's only shout hallelujah alone, they will go home with results to cancel the insults in their lives. On the day of Pentecost, there were three groups of people. The commentators, the spectators, and only few beneficiaries. While others are busy marking your papers. Those who are getting it, they are getting it. May God remove your names from the register of spectators in Jesus' name. I was in Manchester when one of the pastors came to me and said, "Daddy, which club do you belong?" I said, "I don't understand." Club? He said, "Man U or Chelsea?" I said, "None of the two." I said, "Which one do you belong?" He said, "Man U." "Oh, that's good. Since they have been sharing their salary, their money, how much have they extended to you?" He said, "Nothing." "Then you are a spectator. You will never be a spectator in Jesus' name." In Acts chapter 12, verse 23, Acts 12, 23, you remember when King Herod spoke and spoke. The people shouted, "Hey, the voice of a God and not of a man." God sent an angel. The angel struck him, and instantly he became food for worms. The Bible tells us the reason. That because this man did not give God the glory. I want to appeal to all of you. Whatever God does for you, or whatever God does through you, please, sir, please, man, give him the glory. 5 weeks ago, I was in the camp. I made up my mind. It was a vow. And I will never breach it. To give thanks to God. To say thank you, Jesus, at least 70 times a day. And I'm going to do it for the rest of my life till I die. I've made up my mind to say thank you to Jesus, my Lord. I've made up my mind to say thank you to Jesus, my Lord. What about you? I've made up my mind to say thank you to Jesus, my Lord. I've made up my mind to say thank you to Jesus, my Lord. Amen. Because we only say thank you for what we know he has done. What about several other things that he has done for us? When you sleep, some forces are there to work against you, to make sure you don't wake up. But God will raise a standard. Many times we slept, they came and mentioned our names for us to appear Instead of us appearing, Jesus appeared. Because he never revealed it to us, we never said thank you. Can somebody help me say thank you 7 times? Thank you, Jesus. 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 You don't get angry with someone that praises you, do you? No. So the God of wonders can send any of these angels, not necessarily Angel Gabriel or Michael. In fact, they are too busy. God can send Angel Abiodu, Angels Nwako to help you. The crippled beggar at the beautiful gate had seen many men and women of God, but none of them could help him until he located his Peter, Angel Peter. And on that day, thank God, Peter didn't have money. If Peter had given him money, he would have remained there. Peter told him, silver, I don't have, sorry, it's Peter. Peter didn't have silver. He didn't have gold. He said, but I have something that both silver and gold cannot buy. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise and walk. And the man did not walk. Did he walk? No. Until Peter lifted him. Because he was already used to limitation. So God can use anyone for you. Your Peter may not necessarily be a man of God, but he must be a man from God. A man God has sent to you. May I prophesy that before year 2016 expires, your Peter will locate you in the name of Jesus. Possibility number three. I'm not here for sermon. Possibility number three is that God can use any of his anointed to perform wonders. Apart from doing it directly, apart from engaging an angel to do it, he can use any of his anointed to perform wonders. In Acts chapter 2, verse 43, the Bible says, and fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by who? The apostles. The apostles. The original 12 are called apostles. The rest that joined them are disciples. Initially, the apostles. In Acts chapter 5, verse 12, Acts 5, 12, the Bible says, and by the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people. Many signs and wonders. Now, coming to individuals now. In Acts chapter 6, verse 8, Acts chapter 6, verse 8, the Bible says, and Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among the people. Stephen. Remember, no empty sack can stand upright. You have to be loaded before you are needed. So that takes us to another level. God is not looking for ability. He's looking for, availability. If you're available for him, he will empower you to do wonders. But the question is, are you available? Check the Bible. Let us ask God for ability, anointing, anointing. I don't join them because you are wasting your time. The prayer will go into the voicemail. The first thing that God wants is availability. Who shall I send? Who will go for us? If you are available, the next thing is that he will give you responsibilities. After that, he will give you ability. After that, you begin to do exploits. Check the Bible in Luke chapter 9, verses 1 and 2. Luke, the 9th chapter, the first and the second verses. Read the two. The Bible says, Jesus called the 12 apostles. In other words, they were available. Number two, he gave them responsibilities. He said, go out there and preach the kingdom. And then heal the sick. They didn't go to the University of Lagos to study medicine. Yet they were able to heal the sick. Why? After giving them responsibilities, before they left, the Bible says he empowered them. He gave them power and authority. That is ability. So you can see availability, followed by responsibilities, followed by ability. The next thing that followed was that they began to do exploits. Don't ask God to give you an elevator. Ask him to give you a mountain. When God gives you a mountain, he will certainly provide an elevator. And it depends on the height of the mountain. If the mountain you want to climb is just maybe 2 floors, like the size of 2 floors, it will give you a ladder. But if you are going to the 24-story building, God will never give you a ladder. He will give you an elevator. That is the secret of the anointing, ladies and gentlemen. It's not about going to the mountain to pray for 40 days and 40 nights. Make sure you don't fall down from the mountain. Otherwise, you just scatter. Ability goes with responsibilities. You seek responsibilities. If where you are in the church, you are not doing enough for God, go and meet your pastor. Pastor, I need more job, more responsibilities. I gave myself a target to win 1,000 souls every month. Now God gave me anointing. Corresponding ability. I increased it to 5,000 souls every month. God increased the ability. In those days when we were preaching, people were falling under the anointing. Today you don't need to fall. Just say it, he endorses it. My PA will tell you all the politicians who came to us, from the presidency downwards, they won. All. Except two. One governor that I told, if you go, you will fail, sir. He said, but my people say, I said, forget about people. We're talking about God. They won because the Bible says, oh, Michelle, as he has spoken in my ear, so will I do unto you. He said, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it will eat the fruit thereof. He said, thou art snared with the word of your mouth, and thou art taken with the word of your mouth. No wonder he said, let the weak say, I am strong. Let the weak say, I am strong. Don't confess what you see, but confess what you want. God can still make the desirable available, and he can make the desirable affordable. Amen. If you check the Bible, those who said it positively, they got what they wanted. So I increased it to 10,000 souls every month. That's why I don't belong to the church. I'm in the kingdom. My church is the world. Jesus didn't come to build a wall. He came to build bridges. My church, under the bridge. World. Because if I want to limit myself into inside the church, how many souls will I win? The world. So if you see me with any Ogboni people, I'm a person. I'm not there to be a member. I'm there to bring him. Go to king's palaces and bring the kings. You can see the kings now. There are many. By the grace of God. Go to witches and wizards department. And then bring them to church department. Because there are people who will never come to church until you go to them. Are you there, sir? And they will not believe until they see signs and wonders. There was a king who had a crisis, and I told him, forget about that. Just give your life to Christ. It was like, will that solve the problem? I said, the problem has been solved up front. Because what God has finished can no longer finish you. Those who cry unto God will never cry unto man. You just do your rest. Do your best. When you rest in the Lord, he takes care of the rest. Amen. Amen. So, if you want ability to be able to do wonders, anointing, then seek responsibilities. Seek responsibility. Lord, I want to win souls. Lord, I want to do this for you. Lord, I want to do that for you. In the church of God, this is what I want to be doing for the children, in the children department. I tell you the truth, sir. You provoke God to action. You need to take certain action before you see God in action. And that action must provoke divine action before things will begin to function for you. Amen. You may say, but pastor, what about me? Yes, what about you? You are a candidate. You are a wonder. And God can use you to perform wonders. Yes. Amen. Fortunately, the name of Jesus is still available. It's still very, very powerful for us to use and to experience wonders from. He said that in Mark chapter 16. Because these wonders must start from you. And it must start with you. People must see God's handwriting in your life. That was what happened to Anna. Anna had been going to Shiloh, but she had nothing to show for it. But one year, the Lord intervened and gave her Samuel. After the miracle of Samuel, we never heard about Peninnah again. Peninnah, who was mocking, God silenced her forever and ever and ever. Whatever is going to silence your mockers, the Lord will give you tonight in Jesus' name. Before the arrival of Samuel, Anna had a mouth, but she couldn't speak. She couldn't sing. So Samuel came as an opener. And for the first time in many years, Anna composed a song. You can't escape it. This year, God will perform wonders in your life. And you will sing a new song. In the name of Jesus. Before the arrival of Samuel, Anna was in the school of weeping. You know that. But after Samuel came, he came as a wiper to wipe away the tears. Throughout this year and beyond, you will never weep again. You will never weep over your children. Your children will not weep over you. In the mighty name of Jesus. I want to conclude with Mark chapter 16. To let you know that you can do it with God on your side. Mark 16, verses 17 and 18. The Bible says, and these signs shall follow them that believe. Do you believe? It says, in my name. That is what people are no longer using. You see them, they come, bishop, reverend, pastor, zero. Because Jesus himself said in John 15:5, for without me, ye can do nothing. You know the meaning. He says, I am your socket, you are the plug. The plug cannot function independently of the socket. Are you there, sir? Anna said, for by strength shall no man prevail. 1 Samuel 2:9. And God said, it's not by your might, not by your power, but by my spirit. So a wise person will not forget that. That in the name of Jesus, let them know it's Jesus, not you. You are just a messenger. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. I'm coming to that. That means there is deliverance in that name. It's not about asking somebody to bring this, bring that, taking the person to the bar, to the river. Useless. Asking them to bring money. Telling them 250 prayer points. Asking them to fast for 7 days dry. Somebody has problem. You are compounding the problem in the name of deliverance. Is that deliverance? Did Jesus do that? In my name, they will cast out devils. That means there is deliverance in that name. He said they shall speak with new tongues. It means there is divine utterance. He says, they shall take up serpent. That means there is divine lamination. He says, and if they drink any deadly thing, it will not hurt them. That means there is divine immunity in that name. He says, they shall lay hands on the sick, and the sick shall die. I can't hear you. The sick shall do what? Shall recover. That means there is divine healing in that name. Just one name. But the question is, have we been using this name? No. Somebody will come to you now, committee without commitment. We commit crime. We come to you and begin to talk about Nigeria, and then you will join. We don't know where you are going. Well, I know where I am going. Oh, Nigeria, brethren, use your mouth and say something good. Oh, you think we'll continue this way? No way. One day, doors will open in Nigeria. We will no longer endure. We will enjoy Nigeria. He said, we are going to eat the good of the land. And this is our land. It doesn't matter what the enemies are doing. All will be well. Stop blaming anybody. Every day in my family, we pray for Daddy Joe and Mommy Joe and the children. We pray for the president, the vice president, all our people in position of authority, politically. We pray for them every morning, and I'm not on salary. I'm not a prayer contractor. If we all cry unto God over a particular country, God is merciful, but we grumble, we complain, we murmur, we use our mouth to say negative things. In my name, there is deliverance. Jesus went to the tomb of Lazarus. Lazarus that was sick, Lazarus that had died, Lazarus that was buried for many days. In fact, he got to a stage, he was smelling. How do I know? Martha said so. When Jesus got to the tomb and said, remove the stone, Martha said, by now he is stinking. What did Jesus do? He gave thanks to God. Humanly speaking, it was an impossibility. But he says, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? He says, with men, it may not be possible. But with God, all things are possible. Including your own. Brethren, some people are looking down on you now. It's a matter of time. They will look up unto you. When they sold Joseph, they said, we shall see what will become of your dream. And they actually saw. And all of them bowed to him. All your mockers will bow to your maker. Jesus spoke, Lazarus, come forth. When others were saying, it is not possible. Oh, it's too late. If you had come when he was sick, the situation would have been redeemable. But now you came too late. What did he say? He said, your brother will rise again. Amen. That's the way we should talk. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Jesus himself called Lazarus by name. The grave heard his voice and released Lazarus immediately. May I decree to them that whatever is still holding you down, maritally, spiritually, financially, academically, ministerially, we hear the voice of the Almighty God. And you shall be released in the name of Jesus. So tonight, I want you to push you to use that name. Use that name. That name. There is power in that name. You are not there because you want people to know how you can speak. This one has nothing to do with phonetics. Just the name alone. Without adding any ingredient. You are okay. Don't let us deceive people. Praying and shaking your hands. Shaking your head has nothing to do with your prayer. Nobody asked you to shake your hands. I went to pray to preach a crusade. And thousands of people surrendered their lives. I pitied the interpreter because there was no cause for alarm. I was the one talking. He was only interpreting. He was sweating profusely. He was jumping. He was shouting. I was like, take it easy, man. But I couldn't correct him openly. Ha! What's wrong with this man? It's not by might. It's not by power. He said, thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established. When we are praying, oh Lord, oh Lord. Is he deaf? When you are permitted to shout like that, if you are far away from him, he says, where two or three are gathered in his name, he's, right now he's here. Even if you don't talk, what you are thinking, he knows. Daddy, it's not by power. Don't use flesh. The name of Jesus. May I tell you something, sir? I give you 7 days. These wonders will appear in your life. People will see the handwriting of God upon your lives. Now, let me ask you a question. You may say you are dried. Can dry bones live again? Yes. I can't hear you, sir. Yes. Is it possible? Yes. Daddy, Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20. I don't know if you have it in your Bible. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20. Are you there? Yes, sir. Please let me read it. It says, now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. It's not about your degree. It's not about your position. Kai. Some people have said goodbye to you because they thought it is over. The same people will come back to say good morning. Who am I talking to here? Do you believe? Shall we rise? You are going to call on him. And this day we are going to address him as the God of wonders. And we are going to use one name. Not the name of every man or woman, but the name of Jesus. Say, God of wonders. Please perform wonders in my life. Perform wonders in my home. Perform wonders in my business. Go ahead, tell the Lord. He's the God of wonders. Use that name, the name Jesus. He says, if ye ask anything in my name, I will do it. Anything in my name. Anything in the name of Jesus. God of wonders. Perform wonders in my life. Perform wonders in my family. Perform wonders in my business. Let my life advertise you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. You want to do the ridiculous. Because inside the ridiculous, you find the miraculous. Help me put your two hands on your head. Brethren, whatever affects your head affects other parts of the body. You are going to say, God of wonders. Please don't let me be hungry in the kitchen. Go ahead, tell him. God of wonders. I refuse to be hungry in the kitchen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Tell the Lord, I will not be hungry in the kitchen. Yes, Lord. God of wonders, I refuse to be hungry in the kitchen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we are prayed. Brethren, there are chapters and there are chapters. When you are reading some books, you read some chapters, you weep. You read some chapters, you laugh. Like I read a chapter yesterday, and I've not recovered from the shock. I'm still laughing. They said there is a minister of education somewhere in one country, I don't want to mention the name, that he said witchcraft should be introduced in the university as a course, or as one of the subjects. He said, so that at least the students will know how to fly inside the basket, and that will take care of the hold up on the road, and then it will even reduce the consumption of fuel if everybody can fly to wherever they are going. Like, you are going home now, everybody will just fly home. You know, there are some chapters that will make you laugh, but there are some chapters that will make you sad. Brethren, the present chapters you are reading, do you like it? Chapter of sorrow, chapter of lack, chapter of not enough, chapter of sickness, chapter of disappointment, chapter of, so you are going to pray. Say, God of wonders. Please open a new chapter for me. Which month? Tell him. In the name of Jesus, you are praying. God of wonders. Please open a new chapter for me. Chapter of success. Chapter of favor. Chapter of promotion. Chapter of healing. Chapter of holiness. Oh Lord, open a new chapter for me. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I studied my Bible and I discovered that this God of wonders is a commander-in-chief. Elijah found himself in the brook area. You know what the God of wonders said? He said, remain there. Be drinking from the brook. He said, I have commanded the ravens to bring food to you. And they were doing it twice daily. Ravens, for that matter. And they never ate the food. Not only that, they didn't take the food to a wrong person. When the brook was exhausted, the God of wonders told Elijah, relocate to Zarephath. He said, for I have commanded the widow to sustain you. Ha! No wonder the woman didn't say no, because she was acting on that divine instruction. Ravens couldn't eat the food that was meant for Elijah because they were acting on that divine instruction. When God commands anyone to bless you, the person cannot say no. So you are going to pray. Say, God of wonders. Call him again. God of wonders. Wherever my blessings are. Oh, can we take it this way? Say, God of wonders. Please command my helpers to help me. In the name of Jesus. Go ahead, command. Tell the God of wonders to command your helpers, wherever they are, in the north, in the south, in the east, in the west, let command my helpers, let them locate me and help me in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father Lord. Blessed be your name, O Lord. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Brethren, the Bible says, remember ye not the former things. Isaiah 43, verses 18 and 19. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. They are past tense. He said, behold, I will do anything. If I were you, I would believe. He said, I will create a way for you in your wilderness. And I will give you rivers in your desert. Coincidentally, this is the river of joy. When the river of God flows into your desert, you bounce back. You become productive. You become fruitful. Your little efforts will provoke great results. Whatever you sow will germinate and bear fruit. You are going to pray and say, Father, let your rivers flow into my desert. Go ahead, tell the Lord. The God of wonders, let your rivers flow into my desert. Thank you, Father. The God of wonders, let your rivers flow into my desert. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. I don't know. I want to teach you one prayer point. And I want you to help me pray it. I will hear your testimonies through your pastor. Because if I share some testimonies, you may not believe. You are going to say, God of wonders.
God of wonders.
Before Sunday.
Before Sunday.
Give me pleasant surprises.
Give me pleasant surprises.
Oh, yeah, tell him. Pleasant surprises. That will make you say, wow. Beyond your imagination. Beyond your expectation. God of wonders. Before Sunday, I want pleasant surprises. Even beginning from tonight, pleasant surprises. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. There is something you know that I don't know. You know it, but I don't know it. But God knows it. Solomon, God told him, Solo, ask me anything you want. Elijah told Elisha, Elisha, ask me anything you want. King Herod told Herodias' daughter, daughter, ask me anything you want. Check the Bible. They all acquired what they desired. Jesus is saying concerning you and I, if ye shall ask anything in my name, John 14, 14. What did he say he would do? I will do it. Go before your maker. Cry unto him, the God of wonders. Tell him what you desire. Tell him to give you a result to cancel that insult in your life. I don't know what you lack as a family. I don't know what you desire as an individual. It could be in your home. It could be in your business. It could be in your academics. It could be in the ministry. It could be in your personal life. Tell him. He says, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? Tell him. He can still reverse the irreversible. I'm talking about the God of wonders. He can still create a way where there are no ways. I'm talking about the God of wonders. He can still bring us something out of nothing. I'm talking about the God of wonders. If he did it before, he can do it again, and he will do it for you. Your stories will change. Your enemies shall be silenced. The Lord will put them to shame. God will enlarge your coast. That particular thing that you desire, you will acquire it. It may be impossible. Doctors must have given you report. But my God is the unchangeable changer. He will change that report in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name, Lord. In Jesus' name, we are prayed. Because you are here today, the God of wonders will endorse your request. Because you are listening to my voice tonight, the God of wonders will lift you from your present level to a higher level. In the name of Jesus. Shame will never come near your dwellings. Those of you who have challenges, the God of wonders will solve your problems. Those of you who are owing, God will pay your debt. You will never lack money. Money will always be money in your hands. God will command your helpers to locate you. They will help you. You will have more than enough. The enemy shall be put to shame in your lives. The glory of God will manifest in your lives. Oh, I thank you, Father, for answered prayers. God of wonders, we make this promise together that when the wonders begin to manifest in our lives and through us, we shall all give you the glory. Amen. Father, take the glory up front. Amen. And let us retain the blessings. Amen. And let our enemies take the shame. Amen. Thank you, Father, Lord. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. God bless you. Please be seated. Can you shake with your neighbor and say congratulations? It's like you don't understand. Shake hands with another neighbor and say congratulations. Okay? Now, who is going to be the first to testify? A man or a woman? Tall or short? Dark or light? Okay, if you are the one, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Amen. God bless you. The next time you see me, you will disturb me with your testimonies. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now, I have a responsibility. The apostles were available. When Jesus called them, they obeyed. None of them said, no, sorry, I can't come. If any of them had said it, the person would have missed it. Are you there? He called them and they obeyed. They didn't refuse the divine call. It would have been impossible for them to be empowered for signs and wonders if they had not honored that divine invitation. I have good news for you today. The same Jesus that called the apostles before he empowered them to do wonders is calling you and I. Matthew 11:28. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. Let me explain or expatiate. My professional colleague, Peter, you know, it's like we came from the same local government in Ondo State. I used to be a fisherman too, like Peter. So I called him my professional colleague. He went to catch fish one night, and he went with three T's. T number one, he went at the right time. Every good fisherman would know that the right time to catch fish is at night. So Peter went during the night time, which was the right time. Did he catch any fish? Right time failed him. Tip number two, he went with the right tool. He didn't go with a hook, he went with a net. You know, with a hook, you can only catch a fish at a time. But with a net, you can catch as many as possible. Even with the right tool, did he catch any fish? Right tool failed him. Tip number three, Peter went with the right team. He didn't go alone, he went with James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were professionals like Peter himself. my fathers and my mothers, even with the right team, did they catch any fish? So let us conclude. With the right time, with the right tool, with the right team, at the disposal of Peter, he went empty, he came back empty. That you will never labor in vain. His great efforts produce no result. That's the life of many people. You know how to walk, but at the end of the day, you have little or nothing to show for it. But Jesus wanted to use his boat. He surrendered his boat and his life to Jesus. After that, Jesus told him, now, launch into the deep. Whether it is at the right time or not, launch into the deep. Do you know, Peter almost missed it? Because he gave an excuse. Sir, I did it. You know, I'm a professional. I went to School of Oceanography. I have MSc, HIE. In fishing. He said, but at thy word. At thy word. He went and he returned with a net tearing and a boat sinking catch. That was the beginning of the breakthrough of Peter. Assuming he refused to surrender to Jesus that day, he would have remained a fisherman for the rest of his life. You need to take an action before you see God in action. Brethren, I'm learning, and I'm learning fast. If you hold Jesus, you can fall. When challenges of life come, you won't even focus. But when he holds you, you can never fall. So he's saying the same thing. Come unto me, all ye that labor. I called a governor yesterday. He said he was sleeping. When he saw my missed call, he woke up and called. I told him, Your Excellency, leave Labor Party. Labor is not a good name. Or maybe because you didn't come from a poor background. We labored. Names are very important. And if you don't believe me, you want to hire a 3-bedroom flat and they wrote obituary. Or mortuary. Will you rent it? Change. He said, yes, sir. And he changed. And because he changed, he got my support for the second time. Labor. It's not a good name. I'm telling you. Labor. Labor Party. What is Labor Party? Labor industry? Labor? I told the doctors who came to me, medical something, change labor room to delivery room. Those who go to delivery room, they go there to deliver. But those who go to labor room, they go there to labor. Are you not tired of labor? He said, come unto me, all ye that labor.
The Bible tells me that God sits in heaven and his eyes moves to and fro the whole earth, seeking those whose hearts are stayed upon him so that he will show himself strong on their behalf.